this building on our right. Emily Clark just posted about it on Twitter. You just go to the ground floor. Yep. Elevator one.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Dr. Emily.
I've just finished the autopsy, so you're good to go in. It looked like it was just an accident. It looks like you fell into the water and ended up drowning.
Okay.
This is not how I expected today to go. Anyone in the city fucking trust.
He's the only therapist I ever felt I could talk to, no fear.
Yeah.
I felt comfortable with him.
I actually felt like I was talking to a person, not someone who just would keep asking. Why do you think that?
If I had just known CPR, maybe I could have saved him.
Don't, Patrick. Patrick, don't start.
Or if I got there sooner.
Don't start going down that line of thinking, bud. You start going down that line of thinking, and you're never gonna stop.
I
there's a million different things that could have happened. We just got unlucky that this is what happened.
I can't even tell how that happened by what I found.
Was it to kill a Marlin?
As much as I can, and the dick sheep, it just looks like he's just brown.
But the what ifs is a dangerous game.
Just can't pay my respects on you, right? Right, well, so
I'm actually right. If
you want to go in, it's alright. I'm just finishing the autopsy now.
Okay.
I've tried to reach out to Dixie, but there's no response just yet.
I just received word that the elevators are restricted.
I was just supposed to have a nice chill session on the beach.
Yeah. You don't even have an option, to be honest.
Oh, well, I guess
they
just
open all the time.
You just don't know how to use an elevator.
At the time.
Sorry for your loss.
Thank you.
And you write quite lightly through his job at the Los Angeles Metal Group. I worked with him quite a bit sometimes. And I'm really sad to hear this happened to him. You're a treasure to the therapist group. I'm sorry this happened. Hey, Norman.
Hey. Just figured I'd come by. I'm shocked to hear what happened.
Me too.
Yeah.
I hope that your last moments were in pain. I hope you had a safe passing. And I wish you all the best. I'll miss you.
I'm gonna go out in the hallway for a second.
Yeah, I don't know. just need paper. Thought process right now is, oh fuck, Kiki, oh fuck, Patrick, oh fuck, my sisters were finally going to therapy, and she just does not know what to do right now, so she is pacing. Has to tell Ash later, hey, by the way, our therapist is dead. So she is not.
Sorry about that. I just kind of lost my head there.
So, he's a...
Nancy, can you, fix him on the table real quick?
Oh, God.
You can go first, Siobhan. It's fine.
Well, I just... I don't... I...
No, it's fine. Go.
I assume this would be more well lit and more of a party, like an Irish week, and this is not what I expected, and this is much sadder, and I need a moment as well. This is not Irish at all. That's fine. I'm not in Ireland. There's supposed to be beer so you can be celebrating and not be so sad about everything.
It's kind of last minute. I don't think anyone had beer ready.
What happened? Can I... Jonathan...
Wrong.
This is pretty final. He's there on the table. He's looking real cool.
He wanted to do something for himself before his next client.
I was supposed to meet him on the beach.
What happened?
I couldn't find him anywhere. And I don't know if he got sick or something, but... as I went to the water, I found his body under her.
You found his body in the water?
Yeah.
The picture of it all.
Oh my God.
At that time, Jonathan. That...
They all need therapy because of this. Patrick, especially. And there's no more therapists that we trust in this.
Oh, Jonathan, you were fucking too young to go. You're too young, and you deserved better, to be honest. You made the difference in so many people's lives, and you saved a lot of lives, and no one could save yours. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Miss Smellman, the doctor.
Scold me for what I want to say.
I mean, are you gonna be blaming yourself?
I told him not to do it alone. He said he wanted to go swimming and teach himself to swim, and I told him not to do it alone.
And that was a choice that he made. He made a choice. Unfortunately, this is the outcome.
I just wanted him to do something fun for himself.
I know. I know.
Because he said he never did.
There's no priests here, so, through this holy anointing, may the Lord in his love and mercy help you with the grace of the Holy Spirit. May the Lord who frees you from sin save you and raise you up.
He would have yelled at any of us for doing.
Oh God, is someone calling him? Who's calling? Oh God. I wish I could. I wish it was funny. No. I'm looking at him right now.
Oh no, Kirby!
I saw that you were trying to call him, so I figured I should call you.
Kirby, no!
I found out from the person who found him, and then Dr. Emily put out a post on Twitter saying, if anyone would like to visit him, you can come to the morgue. Do you, do you need me to come pick you up?
Jonathan Wright, one of the only therapists in the city that people trust. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Also, I need to check my mic real quick because it seems like it's not
I did not mean a pretty box to see by the guards I've been free to escape immediately.
Okay.
Where it should be.
Drive safe, please. Okay.
Oh yeah, he dead, ma'am.
The fabrics are gonna suffer. That brings me like down to Pixie and Quinn. That's it, man. Jonathan's loss is going to be felt very hard by many people in the city, and they don't realize it right now.
I'll be back.
Okay. Patrick, do you need anything?
Okay. I mean, I'm not good, but...
I just wanted to check on you.
Yeah.
About to have a session with him. Define okay. I don't know.
You don't look really great, that's why I'm asking. You look a little pale. If I was you about to have a session, right? I'm having that because I need it. Oh, God. Hey, listen, do you have the other therapist? Do you have any of the other therapists' information?
No, I don't.
Okay, of course you don't. Can you give me your phone number right now?
I need really Quinn now. And
my phone number?
Yeah, yours.
Here you go.
I've reached out to a therapist and given her your contact information, and she will reach out to you when she is available to help you work through this. So you know you're not abandoned. There are people who are still to help you, and you're not alone. Okay.
Okay.
Right. So God, I can't imagine.
be outside.
Jesus. That's that person who has a horse. I got told that. Excuse me.
Do you know if there's anybody else going to visit him?
I think Kiki said someone was on their way down.
Okay.
She said she was going to come back, yeah.
I'm going to have to tell you some magic contacts via text because none of them are weak.
Oh, where did...
His phone rang.
Okay, I'm gonna go run out there. Sorry about that. That's
what?
Listen, you're gonna be okay, all right? Like I said, a therapist will reach out to you, okay?
Okay.
Just take it easy for now and lots of ice cream and self care. What, Jonathan?
I'm just thinking of how many patients Jonathan has. Because, like, when you look at it, Jonathan's, like, the only really active psychologist in the city. And probably, like, the best psychologist in the city, too. Patrick, I'm gonna head outside, okay?
Yeah, I'm gonna listen. I need some fresh air.
Safe therapy. how I expected the day to go. I was expecting a chill day with Kiki. God damn it, Jimmy. Harvey's right. Just god damn it, Jimmy. Why? She's not gonna marry Ellie and Chad, but fuck that, no.
I need to go for a walk.
Okay, just be careful.
I will.
Especially because we are in the south side.
Yeah, I'm not gonna be in the south side long. I know where I'm going.
I think I'm gonna go walk home too.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just walking straight home.
Do you wanna ride?
Fine.
Yeah.
Thank you, though. You give a hug to Kiki for me, okay?
Hmm?
I said give a hug to Kiki for me.
Either of them walking alone right now, but she's not gonna stop. She's not gonna stop. these aren't gonna hood back.
Yeah.
definitely shrubbery up here. If that's the case, then we are 110% going to Bordeaux. Alright, oh god. No, 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 no. Alright, we might take the Bordeaux route. I think there's only shrubbery up here too. No trees to hit. At least a tree or two up here. Shrubs. But this is V's Overwatch point for the lighthouse. Fun fact. This is V's Overwatch point. I was hoping there's trees up here. It's easier to get to here than going up the backside of Bordeaux to get to the spot that V likes at the top. There's gotta be a tree up here somewhere. Just more shrubs. More shrubs. Aha! There is a tree. Death. Everything. Fuck it all. Fucking point. Everything good fucking dies. What the fuck is the point? Fuck everything. fucking... Kiki blames herself, Patrick blames himself. They even believe me when I tell them there's something they could have done different. So, right now, Veronica's kind of going through the list of people in her life that she loves. She's particularly thinking about Jay. Because Jay is someone who died who was. There's no denying whatsoever that she was at fault for the death of her husband. So when she sees Patrick blaming himself, when she sees Kiki blaming herself, Veronica's taken back to being 18 years old, cuffed to a hospital bed, being read her Miranda rights, because she was responsible for the death of her husband. Then she thinks to herself, they're blaming themselves for something that was after. Especially Kiki. There's nothing Kiki could have done in Veronica's mind that would have stopped this from happening. Swimming accidents happen. People drown. It's not like Kiki held his head under the water and killed him. And so Veronica's thinking right now is very much so trying to figure out how am I going to help my friends to see that they are not at fault for Jonathan's death. How am I going to help them cope with this? How am I going to help them move forward? When she herself hasn't moved forward from the losses she has experienced. She has just bottled up those feelings and it shows other ways. Sorry for what I'm about to do to you. Now, that's not a Norman reference. That is Veronica saying, fuck you to the universe. We're taking people I care about. Fuck the universe for destroying the good things. Thank you.
Thank you.
not you. Who you are grieving, or some of your closest friends are grieving. But who do you go to when that's your therapist? You know, like, who?
our vein is healed.
Oh, please.
Fuck Christ!
Last relationship is something she and John have talked about heavily in the first session.
You look amazing!
So,
let's hang out soon.
Fine. It makes sense.
Hola! Hey!
To go to this spot to talk about the anxiety she currently has. Wrong room. I need to be over on the other room.
You get a DWI in this town and you are fucked.
Ugh, whatever.
I
Fuck
am
it.
So bad at
hey,
remembering places.
Where we hanging
I
out?
Been. I messing this up this badly? Imagine not remembering something important to your character's backstory. The time your character's been in the city. Couldn't be me. Was right. It was the first one. Pretend the last 5 minutes didn't happen. Thank you for the follow. Likewise for Phil. You have joined us on a very... It started as a chill day, and like, I don't usually stream, but once Veronica learn, and Kiki who learned from Patrick what happened to Jonathan. Yeah, the easy hugs. Once she learned that, I was like, hug, I need to stream. So we just find them in a quiet contemplation. She went up to a spot she found near the lighthouse where she could keep the lighthouse in view and fun people in view. Because she never felt comfortable going there without Kiki or anyone else with her. And she found a tree on that road and she did something Jonathan told her to do. Just beat the crap out of the tree. So she did that. Then she carved two things into the tree. Yeah, I've been working on that. Let's see if that fixes things. Because I swapped from using Streamlabs to using OBS Studio, so it's been a process of figuring out the balance. So let me know if that fixes things a little bit, because my mic is up as far as it can go, because unfortunately with how my things are set up, I am further away from my mic than I should be. I'm gonna have a desk soon, TM, and then I can have my mic arm set up soon, TM. I'm definitely not staring at a mountain of things that need to be moved and have had to be moved for months, TM. It's why sometimes I might be a little quiet when I'm talking to people or a little... It's why my stuff is a little funky. It's another reason why I don't stream too often, but I'm like, I need to, for important things, for big things, where V might be off on her own, I do. I'm gonna turn that music down too, because it's a little loud. But as soon as I have that desk set up, I can get my desktop properly set up, which will mean I won't have a fucking laptop anymore. People are always like, wait, you're playing on you're on a laptop when I say that? Like, you know? See if that does anything. I know my mic is always going to be a little quieter though. And also hear the share X button. Fucking birds. Hi. Aww. Yeah, V. I don't know if you were here, but when V went out to her little spot by the lighthouse, she, after hitting the tree, she had a breakdown of how am I supposed to help Kiki and Patrick. Because she heard Patrick blaming himself for not knowing CPR. She heard Kiki blaming herself for telling Jonathan to do something fun. And neither of those things are their fault. And Veronica's conundrum right now, I guess, is there are no more therapists in the city that anyone fucking trusts. She doesn't trust Pixie. She sure as shit doesn't trust Quinn. Bob... is Bob. She likes Bob, but not as a therapist. And Rocky she likes Rocky, but she also knows he's super busy, and she knows every time V tried to get a session with Rocky, it fell through. So now she's just kind of like at a standstill. So we're gonna come back for a drive. She just doesn't know what to do right now. She's waiting for Ashley to wake up so that she can inform Ash. She is trying to figure out, well, what now? Because Ash just had her first session with Jonathan. Sem was supposed to have her first session with Jonathan. And she's just like, the implications of well, what if now they don't want to do therapy at all when they so desperately need it? What? So she's thinking about that, but she's also like, Jonathan was such a positive presence, and she looked forward to getting those phone calls from him, just checking in. She looked forward to those off-topic conversations they'd have. I mean, Veronica was half convinced that Jonathan was an alien trying to learn how to be human, so, you know, after their last session when he asked her about, does she believe in aliens, I don't know why, but Veronica just was just like, I don't know, fam. Seems like he could be an alien trying to learn how humans function. And I know the Gundys have their opening today. So that is another... That's something that she's probably going to go to distract herself. If she doesn't brain herself on a tree. Get her car repaired. She has an A-functioning headlight. Thank you. definitely affected Veronica in the year since I joined the server. The first was Trinity. Then you have Lashandra. And now you have Jonathan. Is definitely not in any mental state to be on duty right now, that's for sure. I just don't know what she's gonna do right now. That's what I'm trying to figure out, is what are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? Tommy, who give me my reimbursement, please. 1,000 or it's only going to be a couple hundred because I did collect it yesterday. Hello, can I get out of the car, please? Thank you. Passive mode's back on. $1,500 more than me out. And the prison's being the prison again. Always good to see you.
Easy again. I left Rust and he told me to come home. He's like, hey. I said, oh, I'm a free agent. He said, I just took it.
Pets are done.
Yeah,
let us begin.
Right now. She doesn't have to think. She can just do.
One more?
Oh. Okay. I think that might maybe is bad. Did it land 21 again? No shot.
You want to go again? Pets are done, let us begin. Another? All bets are closed. Best of luck, everyone.
Lee is just vibing right now. She's not thriving. She's just surviving. And she's trying to come up with a game plan because Kiki sounded so
defeated and broken.
One more?
How much did I get from that? $800?
Bets are done, let us begin. You want to go again? All bets are closed. Best of luck, everyone. Another? Are done, let us begin.
Damn, that was third 12 gone.
One more?
We're still gonna stick with second valve. You're still gonna do 250 on red. It's really hot. Safety bet.
Best of luck, everyone.
Okay. That time I won nothing. Not a thing.
You want to go again? Are done, let us begin.
We'll talk about it tomorrow. Oh, I didn't even bet on even.
Another? Bets are closed. Best of luck, everyone. One more? We gotta
definitely come down. Unless the wheel is warped again. If it's warped again, then I'll just buy the chips. I'll pack. Thank you.
seen him. Alright, yeah, yeah. Yo, tell me when you at the casino and I'll run out. Hey, you Pyro?
No.
Well, who are you?
I'm Veronica, and for some reason, I feel like I can't stop walking right now.
Walk in the direction that you can't stop walking.
Okay.
Cookie, don't kill me. Come on. Why has Cookie got a gun pointing at me, guys? What is this? Aww. Yeah, I thought I was coming with you guys. Come on. Yeah, yeah, bro, there's a reason why Richard couldn't catch me with two tires out.
I think I did. What the hell did he just witness?
Polonica Bestfield. How you going?
Hi, Pact.
Yo, what's up?
Remember how you asked me for drama?
Yeah, that's the therapist, right? I was gonna text him today, actually.
He died today.
Oh shit. What happened?
As I understand it, an accidental drowning or something. He went swimming.
Oh my god. Are you okay?
I'm more worried about others, honestly.
Like who?
Worried about Patrick.
Yeah. Oh shit.
Worried about Kiki. Sam must have missed out.
What hurt like hers? I know Ash told me that she was going to do it. I don't know when though.
It's just, you know, people around us are finally reaching out for help.
Then this happens.
Real patch. There really aren't any therapists I trust in this goddamn city.
Fuck.
There's a reason.
Jonathan was like the only one, huh?
There's a reason so many people went to Jonathan.
He was good.
He was good. He took the time to check in on you, even like when you weren't scheduled for a session.
Yeah.
He's a good guy.
And it was taking a long time for Sam to even build up to wanting to do that. Does Sam know?
Kiki and I were running Dodo when Kiki got the phone call, and Sam was about to run Dodo with Ava. I think they did run Dodo.
Yeah. Oh shit. Sam doesn't know that I know, so I'm not gonna bring it up. Gotcha. I won't like. Yeah, I'm not gonna. I won't mention it. Because I feel like maybe she's kind of sitting on that anyway.
Yeah,
she's had a lot of bad experience with therapists in the past as well.
Supposed to have her first session today. So,
today?
Literally an hour after I got the phone call. After Kiki got the phone call. Would have been the 10th session.
Damn.
That's gonna be a blow to any openness she had to therapy.
Yeah. Oh, man. I think what's important... I mean, she seemed fine. Like, she's in her head right now, but she seemed, like, completely fine at the moment.
Yeah.
But if I notice anything, I'm not gonna push a pry on it. I don't wanna... I feel like if I mention it, it'll just make it worse, so I'm not gonna do that.
I don't wanna start going to Bob again. I like Bob as a person, but he's very much so a... questioning you more. Kind of therapist, you know, how does that make you feel?
Yeah. In my opinion. He's... yeah, okay.
With Jonathan, conversation, just kind of...
And there's no other therapist in the city, really, huh? I know, like...
You got Pixie and Quinn, neither of whom I trust, so...
I think Rocky's a therapist, but I don't know if you know Rocky like that. Or would want to even try.
I have tried reaching out to Rocky in the past, but it's never gone anywhere.
He takes frequent breaks in the city as well.
Yeah, it's just every time I reach out to him, he is wrapped up in something and forgets. And I'm not the kind of person that's going to pester somebody about that kind of thing.
Yeah. I don't know who else there is.
There really is no one else.
Have you thought maybe looking into and researching therapists outside the city?
I don't know. I also don't know where I can go. Anyway.
Damn. And yeah, I was getting open to it too. I think I'm still open to it, it's just... I just don't know who to go to now.
Yeah, I know.
Fuck. Well, I mean, for now, I can just comfort Kiki and Patrick. Whoever else is close to him that you're close to. Make sure they're all good.
Yes.
I hope this hasn't affected any, you know. It seems like you've been making some good progress. I remember you telling me about, like, the stuff that he's told you, you know, take your anger out on, like, trees and stuff. Bushes.
I literally talked to him an hour before back.
We set
up a session for tomorrow.
I'm so sorry.
And just propped back.
Yeah. I know Ash was gonna go too. I don't know if she went or not yet, but does she know yet? I don't think I've seen
her
awake.
She's not awake.
Right. Okay.
It's just like, I can't stop thinking about how many. Because, you know, last time I had a session with him, he was booked solid, like back to back sessions after being out of the city for a week. And I'm just thinking, all these people he was helping.
Yeah.
What happens now?
Mm.
Because I'm sure some of them are going to him for the same reason some of us are, of we don't trust other therapists in the city.
Yeah.
To have our best interests in heart at heart, we don't trust them. And now what?
Yeah, what do you do with all that? That's what I'm thinking, like, what do you do with all that progress that you've made? How do you continue to keep making progress even though he's not there?
How do you... Like, I was thinking about this in the car when I was driving, right? Usually when someone dies and you're grieving, people suggest, hey, go to, you know, it might help to go to therapy to process your feelings. But what do you do when it's your therapist who's dead?
Yeah, who do you see? Yeah. That's fucking crazy.
Like,
who do you see? I mean, at this point, it's who do you keep yourself around? And I think what's important is keeping yourself around, you know, friends and family.
Yeah.
People that are also grieving, you know, and maybe work it out together.
I was just starting to get comfortable opening up more to him. You know, because the first session I had with him, I wasn't comfortable really talking about, you know, what happened with me and my ex-wife. And this session, I was going to bring him up to the university, you know, where Josh was, talk about that stuff, because I feel like, you know, I was going to open up about my anxiety that I have with Randy right
and you know, I don't think it's
I feel weird phrasing it like that, because his death is about more than just, you know, his therapy clients losing someone that they confided. He was a genuinely good guy.
Is kind of opening up. I know opening up is tough for you, and it's tough for Sam and Ash, and you know, all the sisters, really, Raina included. But has talking to him felt like you might be ready to open up to, like, friends? Like, do you think you're there? Could you open up to someone you think you're close to?
I mean, a lot of what I was going to tell him people already about Casey, about a lot of stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
But it's hard for me still to open up about some things because I never want to hurt feelings.
Yeah.
A lot of what I talk to him about is just processing a lot of the feelings I have when things happen. And dealing with my anger and at times resentment towards people. And
yeah. Oh, God. That's so shit. So shit that this has happened.
And I'm just especially worried about Patrick right now.
Yeah. I think what's best is maybe today, you know, make sure he's good and Kiki's good.
He went home.
Oh, did he? Okay.
Yeah. I offered him a ride, but he wanted to walk.
Yeah. That's fair.
I made...
What are you going to do then?
I don't know. I made a... I don't know. I'm checking in on Kiki periodically. Because I'm also worried about her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean, look, when my mom died, I didn't expect that to happen. And mm-hmm. So I just talked to her the night before we had gotten the business set up. And then the next day she was gone. And Randy's calling me, telling me I need to get to the pillbox. He couldn't tell me why. And...
yeah. Life really comes at you fast.
Never know when it's gonna be your
number. Your turn. Exactly. Yeah.
People survive so much crazy shit in this city on a daily basis.
Mm-hmm.
And to think that something as innocuous as, you know, going for a swim could mean the end. Filling up your car could be the end.
There's death. Death is around every corner here.
Yeah, well, death can go fuck itself.
Yeah.
I actually carved fuck death into a tree along with fuck the universe.
Yeah,
I apologize to that tree because Jonathan told me after I'm done taking my aggression out on the tree, I shouldn't apologize, and he gave me permission to stab the tree.
Yeah.
And I did stab the tree, I just happened to carve it instead of...
stab all the trees you need to, Veronica.
I intend to. Away from population centers so locals don't get scared and call the cops on me, but...
it's better you stab trees with a weapon than, you know, beat up dumpsters with your fists. I would rather you, you know, stab trees, whack trees, kick trees, kick bushes. Bushes deserve it too.
Yeah, I was... felt like I'm just screaming into the void because no one's listening. Yeah.
Well, I'm here if you want to talk. I don't know how much help I can be, but...
yeah, it's just like screaming at the universe, like, fuck you, fuck death, fuck it all. It's...
mm-hmm.
Why can't it be people like Kevin that are dead? Why can't it be people like Mel? Why can't it be people like the Terror or anyone that's ever hurt people? It's always,
I don't know,
people who have done nothing wrong.
People always say that the good die young and the old get to live a very, very long life, and I never understood why either. Yeah, because like you said, it could be, you never know when it's your number. You never know.
Like, I joked last night that if Randy accidentally shot me, it'd be the last time he saw me, you know, because you never know.
Mm-hmm. I say that to Sam too, if she ever stabs me again. That could be it, because you never know.
You never know.
Exactly. That's why it's important to keep your loved ones as close as possible and let them know you love them every day.
Yeah.
You're there for them every day.
Man, I really wish I still had that snowball I got last night.
You got a snowball? What the fuck?
Yeah, there were these like animals at the hospital and they were having a snowball fight, and I asked one really nicely if I could have some snowballs, and it gave me a couple. And then I threw it at JB and he ducked like a little bitch. I wasted my last snowball on JB.
Fucking JB. He should have taken it like a man.
So.
Well. You know to call whenever you need someone to talk to him here.
And you know, I was looking forward to telling Jonathan about that and have him look at me like I was crazy. Because he had a habit of doing that whenever you'd mention animals doing something weird. I told him about how I saw a crow ocean dump a man once, and he definitely thought I was losing it.
Your fixation with crows lately has got me concerned. You saw a crow ocean dump a man.
I swear to God, I saw a crow ocean dump a man.
What the fuck? Maybe you are crazy.
Okay.
Although this city, anything's possible.
Packed. Considering literally I saw animals possible. Having a snowball fight last night, do we really think it's outside the realm? And did you see that gif of a seagull or whatever picking James Randall up?
Actually, you're right. Yeah, I was about to say that.
So yes, that I'm the crazy one.
This city maybe drives us all mad, I think.
It's something.
Miss the Mirror Park Lake is just too
God,
oily.
It's contaminated us all.
Exactly. Oh no, man. Oh no.
What are you up to today?
I've been awake for I think I've slept 2 hours in the last 38.
Jesus.
I mean, after I left the city a couple of days ago to get Sam, I didn't leave that city until I brought it back, and then we got back yesterday, and then we went to sleep and then woke up for Adonis's wedding, and we've been awake ever since.
How are things with you guys?
I think pretty good, you know. I think good.
Okay.
Obviously me, you know.
Oh,
her not knowing. Oh, is she?
I'm assuming she's at her house, because I'm at the house right now, too.
Yeah, call her and talk to her and let her know, I guess, yeah.
Her twat, though. That day is going to be a great day. Alright.
Well, it's like you guys know before... It's like you and your sister telepathy, man. It's like you guys know right before anything... Yeah, right before they get the news. That's crazy.
I'll talk to you in a bit, Doc.
It's like you guys know.
I don't think she does.
just fucking around. Alright.
Alright, I'll talk to you.
Call
later,
if you need us, alright?
Yep.
Stay safe.
Alright.
And we'll talk soon. Bye bye.
Veronica.
Hello, we need to talk.
What's up?
I'm just gonna rip this bandaid off. Jonathan died today.
I'm gonna need you to say that again.
Jonathan died.
I really hope you're talking about a different Jonathan.
No, I am talking about Jonathan. He died swimming. Apparently.
Swimming?
Accidental.
Okay.
I gather Patrick was there.
Mm-hmm.
So Patrick's not doing so hot.
Okay.
Sam was supposed to have her session with him.
Yeah, I was supposed to have my second session with him today.
Accidental swimming. I guess he must have been in the water a little too long.
Huh. Here.
I were at Dodo Road. Yes, it was Patrick.
Huh, okay. How are you guys doing?
We're
Mm-hmm. Yeah, me too. In the city.
Not only was he one of the only good therapists in the city, he was a decent person.
Yeah.
A great person. So.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go inside and cook for a while.
Okay.
Probably. I don't know. But I think Bundy said something about the flower shop opening today. I think.
Okay.
I don't know. I was having like, a grand opening conversation last night up at the hospital because I had came back to talk about the flower shop that was opening. And
Gotcha. Are they doing like a grand opening event?
I don't know.
Is it just like a low key thing?
No idea. So I'll probably head up to that. I might just ride around with you for a bit and then.
Okay, yeah.
I am in no place to continue driving.
Yeah, you definitely shouldn't be.
Do you want to take your bike or my car? My car is in a hot mess right now.
It's up to you. Were you gonna go in and cook?
Maybe later.
Okay.
Do you want to take my car or your bike?
I don't really care. I won't lie to you. I was gonna go to the casino.
Oh, I was just there.
Yeah, I'm gonna gamble.
Alright, I might go inside and cook for a bit then.
It's up to you, you're welcome to come with, but
I have a whole host of ingredients in my fridge and a lot of baking.
Alright, well call me later then, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Love you, V.
Love you too. Perfect timing for dinner. And this is where I'm going to be ending my stream. V's still going to be around the city. Thanks for hanging out. This was emotionally terrorizing.